294-0970 into the Billings Morning News and News Talk 95.5. Steve Zabawa here with me. I'm Living Large, and Harv, part of the Billings Morning News, talking marijuana, talking, well, all illegal drugs, really. Safe Montana, safemontana.com. And, I mean, it does encompass, I mean, this is outside of just marijuana, correct, right, Steve?
Yeah, it handles any Schedule I illegal drug on the Food and Drug Administration's Controlled Substance Act. So there's about 20 of them, actually.
724 and 294-0970 into our studio. Questions, comments for Steve Zabawa from Safe Montana, safemontana.com. And thanks for calling. All right, John, what is your question for Steve Zabawa for Safe Montana? Go ahead, sir.
My question stems from both the Supremacy Clause and the 10th Amendment of the Constitution. The Supremacy Clause says, "This Constitution, the laws of the United States, which shall be made in pursuance thereof, and all treaties made, or which shall be made under the authority of the United States, shall be the supreme law of the land." The 10th Amendment says, "The powers not delegated to the United States by the Constitution, nor prohibited by it to the states, are reserved to the states respectively or to the people." The two taken together, it's obvious why the 18th Amendment was required to prohibit alcohol, and cannabis prohibition enjoys no such documentation or authorization. So my question to Mr. Zabawa is, under what constitutional authority is the Controlled Substances Act enacted?
All right, Steve.
Well, at some point in time, the Food and Drug Administration was instructed by Congress and the President to have five schedules out there to figure out what were the most dangerous drugs and what should not be allowed out in the marketplace with just no supervision. And marijuana was put on the Schedule I at that time, and it's never been able to be taken off because it is dangerous. You know, it's when you smoke it, you instantly get high, and the THC content today is five times stronger than when I was a high schooler. So I don't know how strong that is, but it's very, very strong. It does a lot of damage to lungs on respiratory. It has issues with anybody under the age of 25 as far as for their brain and the ability to memory and process. And there's a lot of negative effects as far as there is no such thing as a safe cigarette. And that's why the FDA's got it on there. There could be some possible medicinal uses of marijuana, and I'm all for that, but we need to do it the correct way, which would go through a pharmacy, a doctor that can actually handle it. There's no doctors in town that I'm aware of that will handle it because it's illegal federally. So the Billings Clinic, St. V's, they stay away from it. So if you want to get medicinal help, you got to go to the back alley, and I don't think that's a safe way to do it. That's why we call it safemontana.com.
And I think that a number of people in what you just said, that you're all for medicinal marijuana, I don't think a lot of people thought you were, to be quite honest.
Well, no, I've got no problem with it. I just don't. The recreational piece has hurt my family in so many different ways. I can't even explain it to you. It didn't take all on the rest of the hour.
Well, we have a four-hour talk show, Steve.
maybe we do have enough time.
If need be.
So, bottom line is, I've just heard one story after another throughout the community. I've talked to about 5,000 people in the last 10 days. We have 11 days left to get our signatures, and it's not good stuff.
We'll talk more of the signatures and more on the issue and the topic this morning. Safe Montana, no illegal drugs in Montana. Steve Zabawa is our guest. It'll be 75 today. Steve Zabawa with us. Safe Montana, Safe Montana. .com. No illegal drugs, and more commentary from Steve coming up in a second here. And you too. Questions, comments. Got a whole bunch of things on Facebook you said yesterday. So if you want to call the show and relate that to Steve and the topic, then now's your time to do that. And we'll go over some of the Facebook comments on the way too. Comments.